Well, this is new. I haven't been in here for a while. This says, between 1940 and 1945, the women and the men who lived in Saint-Denis were engaged in movements of resistance for the liberation of France. Many were arrested, tortured, subject to the firing squad by the German Nazi regime, with the complicity of French authorities of the Vichy government. Here lie 24 among them. The Municipal Council of Saint-Denis gives homage to these fighters for freedom. And here are names. Oh, I can actually smell this. Not a very good sense of smell. It smells nice. These are World War I graves, and they're beautifully maintained. They put proper plaques in them, it looks like recently, with a photo, if they could find it, of what the person looked like, because these are getting really old, and they just have names. So it looks as though they found photos for pretty much everybody. And this one just has the date of death in 1942. I don't think they know the date of birth. I get very, very angry when Americans say, well, you know, just capitulators and, you know. I would tell them to shut up. If they could see so many of the World War I sites and museums in various countries, France, Belgium, etc., they would shut up. I mean, you really realize when you can actually see the equipment and the photos and the horror and the details. You can see why they were not looking forward to another world war or a big war at the end of the 30s. And then right after that, they had the Spanish flu, and that took way more people than World War I. I mean, that was a global pandemic. My husband's grandmother, maternal grandmother, who I never met alive, but my first time out in Brittany was in 95, and she died in August of that month. And I went out there to a three-day country French Breton funeral, Catholic funeral. Very strange, a lot of pagan stuff going on there. And they had her laid out at home on a table and stuff like that. It was quite weird, very strange rituals with the priest, and everybody was doing a lot of strange stuff. I had to be really careful about my behavior. It was a long, hot 3 days. Anyway, she was very tiny, and this guy died in 65, quite young, of an accident. Oh no, that was a girl. Okay. And she was, everybody had to be a volunteer for victims of the Spanish flu, and she remembered having to carry around a step stool just to get up to the people in their beds. That's how little she was. She was really small. I saw her. She was dead, but the French are tiny. Little peasant woman. And, yeah, the Vichy government was quite horrible. And when the Nazis asked for Jews to be turned over, they actually didn't ask for children. But the French turned them over. And they were deported from Drancy, which is really quite adjacent to where we live in Saint-Denis. and virtually none of them survived. I mean, these were unescorted kids. You know, they were supposed to die anyway. It's really terrible. I've never heard of any one of them surviving. And some people in France, a few people in France, did take a big chance, and they did take the kids, some kids, and they did hide and help Jews to the extent they could. And then when they got caught, they were killed, no doubt about it. So it was very terrifying. I remember my father-in-law talking about being a saboteur as a boy. He was about 10, 11 years old. He said all they could do in Poitou-Charentes, these peasant kids, was to destroy the electrical wires, the telephone wires, the telegraph wires. You know, they would throw rocks at them, whatever it took. Because, yeah, then they wouldn't have them, but then the Nazis wouldn't have them either. And they were risking their lives, too. But he said that they all felt that they had to do that, to make it as hard for them as could be. So I get really annoyed when Americans call them, from that Simpsons cartoon, hello to George Meyer, capitulation monkeys. I mean, that's just an insult. You don't know anything about history, and you can't imagine. You couldn't have walked a mile in their shoes, most of them. And frankly, couldn't walk a mile in my shoes either today for my life and coming over here and other things. So, you know, that's what I say. Well, I'm glad I got that done. Now I have to go home and make lunch. I think it's going to be a little bit late. I don't know what time it is. Okay. See, there's the basilica. Tons of construction going on all over Paris. Oh, there's the Formula. Oh, it's still only 39 euros for a room for two or three. This is the one to go to in Paris, not the others. They're not in such good locations, and they cost more. Bye-bye.